A microtiter plate after and met at assay. Increasing amounts of cells resulted in increased purple coloring. The MTT assay is a colorimetric assay for assessing cell metabolic activity. NAD-dependent cellular oxidoreductase enzymes may, under defined conditions, reflect the number of viable cells present. These enzymes are capable of reducing the tetrazolium dimethyl 3-2,5-diphenyl tetrazolium bromide to its insoluble formazan, which has a purple color. Other closely related tetrazolium dyes including XTT, MTS and the WSTs, are used in conjunction with the intermediate electron acceptor, 1-methoxyphenazine methosulfate. With WST1, which is cell-impermeable, reduction occurs outside the cell via plasma membrane electron transport. However, this traditionally assumed explanation is currently contended as proof has also been found of MTT reduction to formazan in lipidic cellular structures without apparent involvement of oxidoreductases. Tetrazolium dye assays can also be used to measure cytotoxicity or cytostatic activity of potential medicinal agents and toxic materials. MTT assays are usually done in the dark since the MTT reagent is sensitive to light. MTT, a yellow tetrazol, is reduced to purple formazan in living cells. A solubilization solution, usually either dimethyl sulfoxide, an acidified ethanol solution, or a solution of the detergent sodium. Dodecyl sulfate and diluted hydrochloric acid is added to dissolve the insoluble purple formazan product into a colored solution. The absorbance of this colored solution can be quantified by measuring at a certain wavelength by a spectrophotometer. The degree of light absorption is dependent on the degree of formazan concentration accumulated inside the cell and on the cell surface. The greater the formazan concentration, the deeper the purple color and thus the higher the absorbance. XTT2H tetrazolium 5 carboxynolide has been proposed to replace MTT, yielding higher sensitivity and a higher dynamic range. The formed formazan dye is water-soluble, avoiding a final solubilization step. Water-soluble tetrazolium salts are more recent alternatives to MTT. They were developed by introducing positive or negative charges and hydroxy groups to the phenyl ring of the tetrazolium salt. Or better with sulfonate groups added directly or indirectly to the phenyl ring. MTS522H tetrazolium, in the presence of phenazine methosulfate, produces a formazan product that has an absorbance maximum at 490 nanometers in phosphate-buffered saline. The MTS assay is often described as a one-step MTT assay, which offers the convenience of adding the reagent straight to the cell culture without the intermittent steps required in the MTT assay. However, this convenience makes the MTS assay susceptible to colorimetric interference as the intermittent steps in the MTT assay remove traces of colored compounds, whilst these remain in the microtiter plate in the one-step MTS assay. Precautions are needed to ensure accuracy when using this assay, and there are strong arguments for confirming MTS results using qualitative observations under a microscope. WSTs are a series of other water-soluble dyes for MTT assays, developed to give different absorption spectra of the formed formazans. WST1 and in particular WST8352H tetrazolium are advantageous over MTT in that they are reduced outside cells, combined with PMS electron mediator, and yield a water-soluble formazan. Finally, WST assays can be read directly, give a more effective signal than MTT, and decrease toxicity to cells. Tetrazolium dye reduction is generally assumed to be dependent on NAD-dependent oxidoreductase enzymes largely in the cytosolic compartment of the cell. Therefore, reduction of MTT and other tetrazolium dyes depends on the cellular metabolic activity due to NAD flux. Cells with a low metabolism such as thymocytes and splenocytes reduce very little MTT. In contrast, rapidly dividing cells exhibit high rates of MTT reduction. It is important to keep in mind that assay conditions can alter metabolic activity and thus tetrazolium dye reduction without affecting cell viability. In addition, the mechanism of reduction of tetrazolium dyes, i.e. intracellular versus extracellular, will also determine the amount of product. Additionally, proof has been provided as to the spontaneous MTT reduction in lipidic cellular compartments/structures, without enzymatic catalysis involved. Nevertheless, even under this alternative paradigm, MTT assay still assesses the reduction potential of a cell. As such, the final cell viability interpretation remains unchanged. In studying the viability of cells seated on 3D fiber scaffolds, the thickness of the scaffolds may influence the MTT assay results. Thanks for watching.